If you have listened to and understood the last four videos, you should have a rather good idea about how to sketch fully factorised polynomial functions. Here in New South Wales, Australia, when students finish school at the end of year 12, they sit for an examination called the Higher School Certificate. And in that examination, most years, they're required to sketch a polynomial. About half the time, the polynomial function's already factorised for them, and the other half of the time, there's a small amount of factorising required. What I propose to do today is to engage in a kind of marathon session where I sketch for you the graphs of the last half dozen or so of these questions. I'll tell you which year they come from and what question in the exam papers they are. That's for the benefit of students in Australia. And I propose to do it in fairly quick succession, and I'll even try and do it in the one take, so there'll be no editing, and we'll see how we go. But look, I'm going to start with 2004. So here we go, the 2004 HSC examination. Question 4B was to graph this function. It was not fully factorised. X cubed minus 3x squared. Quite simple. As you can see, it has a common factor of x squared. And to find the roots, we set the function equal to 0 for the roots. And we have roots, therefore, at x equals 0, a double root, and at x equals 3. Draw our axes. Root at 0, I'll put a little 2 to remind me it's a double root. Another root at 3. The leading coefficient is positive and 1. So the graph is going up here. It passes straight through the 2. As it comes up, because it's double root, it behaves like an upside down parabola. That's the sketch for the 2004 HSC question. Now, of course, these questions, I must add, also require calculus to be done to find the maximum, minimum points of inflection and things like that. So I'm not giving you the whole story, but that's the basic shape for the curve. So, let's go on. I realise I missed one, 2003. I have them written down below the board here. Question 5A, the function value was, or the function was, x to the 4 minus 4x cubed. It also happened to be the 2007 question, question 6b in that paper. Common factor of x cubed, we set it equal to 0 for the roots. I won't write 4 roots there. The roots, of course, are at 0 and at 4. And the root at 0 is a triple root, which means that the curve will pass through it in an S shape. We draw the axes. Root at 0, root at 4. Being a positive leading coefficient, the graph is going up. It passes through 4, comes up towards 0, but instead of bouncing or going straight through, it goes through with a slight bend like that. That's the graph for those two HSC examinations. I hope you can see the principles that we talked about being applied in these questions. 2005, question 4b. The function this time was a little bit tricky. It is factorised, but not fully. Now, I hope you can see that we have a difference between squares here. This factorises into x minus 3, x plus 3. And you can see now that we have a factor here twice. So it was a little bit of a trap. Yes, we did have a root at minus 3, but it's actually a double root. So we set equal to 0 for the roots, and the roots are at minus 3 and plus 3, bearing in mind that minus 3 is going to be a double root. Draw our axes. Plus 3 is going to be a normal root. Minus 3 is going to be a double, so I'll put a little 2 to remind me. Again, positive leading coefficient, because it's a plus x cubed, so it is heading upwards as x increases. The curve passes directly through the root at 3, and as it comes up to this root, it's going to behave like a parabola and bounce. And there it is for the 2005 HSC paper. We had one in 2006. Question 5A. The function was 2x squared, 3 minus x. And hopefully from the third video, I think it was, where we discussed factors that seemed to be in reverse, in other words, a minus 1 had not been removed, we actually fully factorise this. So we have minus x, and minus minus 3 is plus 3. This is the form we like, and we can see the leading coefficient is minus 2. We set it equal to 0 for the roots, and we have x equals 0 is one root. It's there twice, it's a double root, and we have another root at 3. So let's see what this looks like. The root at 0 is a double. The root at 3 is a normal root, but because the leading coefficient is negative, the curve's going downwards as x increases, and because there's a 2, it's rather steep. 3 is a normal root, so it passes straight through there, comes down towards the 0 root, and because it's a double, it behaves like a parabola and bounces off. And that's the curve for the 2006 HSC paper. Now, I told you the 2007 one was like the 2003 that we did before. 2008, we're nearly there. Question 8A. The function this year was another quartic, x to the 4 minus 8x squared. You can see there's a common factor of x squared. And I hope you can see that because we have a subtraction, a minus sign here, that we do have a difference between squares. It's a little bit ugly. We're going to have a third, or thirds. X minus root 8, x plus root 8. If you'd like, we can simplify that a little bit. I don't want to get into discussing thirds too much in this video. We set it equal to 0 for the roots. Notice we actually have a double root and two singles. So x equals 0 is our double root, and we have a root at 2 root 2 and another one at minus 2 root 2. Now, where are they located? Well, square root of 8 is just a little bit less than the square root of 9. So it must have a value just slightly under 3. So we have a double root at 0. We have one root just under 3. So there's 3. I'll just put a little marker there and call that root 8. And we have one the same distance in the negative direction, minus root 8. The leading coefficient is positive, so we know the curve is going upwards here. And these two are normal roots, so the curve will pass directly through them. As it comes up to the root at 0, because it's a double root, it's going to behave like an upside down parabola. and then it's going to pass up normally through that route. You can see why quartic equations, fourth powered equations, are often looking like a W. That's the graph for the 2008 HSC exam. And again, of course, we use calculus to find the fine detail. Question 6A. The function for this year's HSC was x plus 2 times x squared plus 4. Now this was an interesting year. It was the first year that we had a factor, a quadratic, that could not be factorized in the real number, in real numbers. Consequently, if we find the roots, there is only one real root at minus 2, which means that when we graph this particular function, all we know is that it goes through here. We know that it's a cubic equation, and it's a positive cubic equation, so we know it looks a bit like that, or might have a slight bend like this, or even a larger one. We don't know that yet, and the problem is we don't know whether the kink is down here or up here. So a calculus was required to find finer detail this year. I'll talk about that in other videos, but not in this one. And finally, I just looked up on the internet for 2012, I forgot to write down which question it was, but the function was 3x to the 4 plus 4x cubed minus 12x squared. You can see this is rather more complex than any of the preceding ones. Certainly, x squared is a common factor. There is no common number numerical factor, so we take x squared out, and we now have a quadratic. We could attempt to factorize it. There are a variety of methods, and I will be showing some videos on how to factorize quadratic equations. But for the moment, we'll just run a quick test. Off on the side of our page, we'll work out the discriminant, which is b squared minus 4ac. B squared is 16. A times c is minus 36. So that's 16 plus 144 equals 160. That is positive, so we're going to have two distinct real roots, but unfortunately they're not pretty ones. This means that we can actually write our roots. We have a double root at 0, and our two roots for this are going to be at minus b. Oh, I'd better write the formula. Minus b is going to be minus 4. We have already worked out the discriminant. It's 160. And 2a is 6. Minus 4 plus or minus. Now you can see this is 16 times 10, and we take the square root of 16, and we can divide 2 out as a common factor. I must say, in this particular year, they did not require you to find the roots, and you can see this is a particularly nasty one. The exam question for 2012 was concentrating almost exclusively on the calculus. But if we were to sketch this, what's the value? Well, root 10 is just over 3, it's just over the square root of 9. So we've got something just over 6 here. So minus 2 plus 6 and a bit is 4 and a bit over 3, so it's just over 1 and a third. So I'll do some approximations here, approximately. And the other one's going to be minus 2 minus 6 and a bit is minus 8 and a bit. So it's just under minus 3, say minus 2 and 2 thirds. I have not left room for graphing. I'll do it over here. This is the last of the exam questions I'm going to discuss in this video. We have a double root, remember, at 0. I'll write a little 2 to remind me. At about 1 and 1 third, there's a root. I'm not even going to try to write that in there. There's no room. And at minus 2 and 2 thirds, I hope this fits on the video, I think it should, we have a normal root there. Leading coefficient is plus 3, so we know it goes upwards and quite steeply. Passes normally through here, wants to come up to this one. Being a double root, it will bounce off as a parabola, or in that parabolic shape. Because these roots are further apart than these two, I would anticipate this would drop a bit further and pass up through there. And that would be the shape of the graph for that year. So there it is. We've summarized in 4 lessons how to graph polynomials using our knowledge of roots. And we've now seen 2, 4, 6, about 7 different questions from higher school certificate standard papers. I hope you found that useful and profitable. And I look forward to seeing you in another video. Thank you.